And I'm back again. So, let me try and zoom in on these females. The one that's right there, I think she's paired up with the male. They're like sneaking up on her in the corner. Because they definitely do not want her near their breeding site when they breed. The natural thing. So, you know. One of them loves this one, but you can see that little black stripe that's one of the females. I think that's the egg is easy. There's a Cory down there eating on it. Corys do not get baby tears or like glosso or whatever it's called, or like the foreground plants that aren't hardy, like dwarf sag will be okay with them, but don't get anything like baby tears. Because then they're going to uproot it if they're not established. Though they're great fish anyway. I haven't had them breed. Dustin's had them breed. Ross Boy's had them breed. I haven't had them breed. And I don't know why. I've fed them lots of live stuff. Some frozen stuff. I don't know. Speaking of frozen stuff. After this video. Tomorrow. Or tonight, I'm gonna get started on the Back to the Basics videos. I know Ted Judy's already doing Back to the Basics stuff, but I just wanna, even experienced people have to watch this. Back to the Basics. It's nice to know other people do things differently, and all the beginners who've seen this, know that, know what to do. This is an actually nice, this is a pretty good angle. I took a picture of my intro for my camera. Let me try and zoom in on a female. I'll zoom in on Lemon Tetras. Don't remember the scientific name. I might post it or not. Definitely a beginner. Almost all Tetras are beginners. They're very forgiving. They like regular tropical fish water, 75 degrees to 80 degrees. If you want to breed them, make it slowly go up, and they should breed in the morning if you put a pair in. Females are a lot stockier, maybe because you know the eggs and stuff. It's not really that much that gender difference because they're tetras. Most tetras don't have that big of a gender difference. So that's pretty much it. pH, low pH for tetras. All tetras love pH below 7.0. Including the neon tetra, true classic. Same care as the lemon tetras. They get smaller, so make sure you don't keep them with anything bigger than an angelfish. Angelfish might actually eat them if they get big enough. But nothing bigger than a medium-sized angelfish, because then they'll get eaten. Like, don't put them with fire mouse that, you know, are gonna get too big. Like, I put them with my grandma's fire mouse, they got eaten, or died and got eaten, I don't know. I don't really care. I'll just tell her to get some angels or something. What else? Tetras. Breeding is simple, but kind of annoying because they're gonna eat their eggs. Kind of weird, right? Pretty much it. Later tonight or tomorrow I will start the Back to the Basics. See you. Alright, I'm back. Sorry for my sister and her friends talking in the background. They can hear that. Alright, so female got XZZ. It's really angry at the other female cockatoides. I don't know why, but she is. More importantly, I filled the tank back up because I was kind of annoyed with the whole low level. I don't know. If you think I should put it back, comment or tell me or email me or something. Because I'm still not totally sure. It looks nice. Because if you can see, it's most clear it's ever been since I filled the tank up. It's only been this clear twice. And that's one before this and then this. I don't know why does that every... I think it's because I put a whole bunch of plants in here. The more plants you have, the lower the nitrates, the lower the ammonia, the lower the nitrites, and the clearer the water gets. Plus, I have a giant sponge filter. I have some, like, driftwood, a mother box. Yeah, it looks like a bird. I'm not sure if you can see that or not. It's kind of creepy. In the head, I think you should probably see that. Yeah, there's a cave in there. I'm hoping somebody will find it and breed me. I figured out that only this cockatoidy female is the pure orange fly. I'm hoping I can get a 75-gallon to expand my distance, get some more cockatoidies, maybe some agassiz, or agassizies in here, have them breeding stuff. 75 gallons pretty long. That should do fine. It'll probably reach the light, sunlight, but, you know, it's better for the plants. I'll just put a whole bunch of swords around there, or something, maybe some mancharsis or something. Right there is the female agassi or agassizi. One of them. I don't remember which one. This is a pretty bad zoom on this camera. She's around the lutea. Dwarf cichlids. Here's a tip on pretty much all cichlids or all dwarf cichlids in general, and all fish like them in tetras and stuff. If you don't have them in hiding places, like a lot of plants or anything, they're gonna hide in a corner and never come out and then die of stress. Make sure you have lots of plants like I do, or a lot of hiding places with driftwood, or stones, or coconut caves, or whatever, so they can feel secure. Like, before my cockatoides would never come out, he would just hide, and I never saw him, and I was really angry because I paid some good money for that. And then I started putting a lot of plants in there, and then he started coming out a lot more often. Actually, my other one died, but I got some new ones. I already told you that. So, they're also harem spawners, so that should actually... He was the dominant one, so it's actually kind of good. He has better colors and everything. So, the Tia is a good plant. It propagates by runners, which means that it'll pretty much shoot off little stems underneath the sand or gravel, and then plants will pop up. Dwarf sag, if it's a small tank, like 10 gallon, if you're like in college, it's a 10 gallon, you can like do that. What else? Amazon swords, and other crypts, like the Lutea, and Java moss over there, definite. A lot of caves. What else? Another water sprite is a beginner plant. You can float it or you can plant it. I have it floating, even though I have a planted tank. It doesn't create that big of a shadow because I have really nice, powerful light LEDs. So yeah, pretty much it. What else? If I can't think of anything, I'll shut up. Alright, I just did one on cichlid, so... alright, I'm gonna stop it and then come right back.